Now I'd like to move on to the field of orthobiologics and regenerative medicine, and we'll first talk about stem cells. Stem cell therapies are a cutting-edge treatment and offers high hopes for those suffering from osteoarthritis. However, while there has been substantial media coverage and marketing efforts surrounding stem cell therapies, they often highlight anecdotal success stories. And while personal stories can be very compelling, they can create a perception of effectiveness that may not be fully supported by clinical evidence. So let's briefly explore the three main types of stem cells used in osteoarthritis treatments. First, there's bone marrow aspirate concentrate, or BMAC for short. BMAC is obtained from bone marrow and is usually harvested from the patient's iliac crest in the pelvic bone. Next, we have adipose stromal vascular fraction, also known as SVF. SVF is derived from fat tissue and is harvested through liposuction. Last, there are stem cells from umbilical cord, which are ethically sourced and processed for clinical use. Each stem cell treatment, whether it's BMAC, SVF, or umbilical cord derived, shares a common goal. They utilize mesenchymal stem cells and growth factors to potentially repair and regenerate damaged tissues like bone, cartilage, and connective tissue. In addition, these therapies also aim to reduce pain and inflammation through their anti-inflammatory and immunomodulatory effects. So that's all in theory, but what does the actual clinical evidence indicate? While numerous case reports and some smaller studies suggest positive outcomes with stem cell therapies, the overall evidence remains inconclusive. That's why the results from this large randomized controlled trial were particularly significant. The study investigated the three types of stem cells. Again, that's BMAC, SVF, and umbilical cord tissue. The researchers compared each of these three stem cell injections to corticosteroid injections and reported outcomes at 1 year. The results showed that there was no difference in pain scores between any of the stem cell therapies when compared to cortisone injections. In addition, no treatment group saw any notable improvement in MRI scores. This suggests that none of the stem cell treatments helped repair or regenerate anything within an arthritic knee. Now, I want to reflect on these findings and emphasize a couple key points. First, this was a very well-conducted study with a large sample size of over 400 patients. This is significantly more than the 20 to 30 patients in other clinical trials and therefore lends greater reliability to its findings. Second, the study questions the effectiveness of stem cell treatments compared to corticosteroid injections for knee osteoarthritis. This raises an important question. Is it worth paying thousands of dollars for a treatment that is not outright superior to less expensive alternatives? Some critics would argue that a one-year study may not be sufficient to evaluate the long-term benefits or structural improvements that stem cell treatments could provide. However, it's important to note that individuals considering stem cell therapy often seek immediate results and may be reluctant to invest a significant amount of money in a treatment that requires several years to potentially show benefits. For all these reasons, I currently do not recommend stem cell treatments for the treatment of osteoarthritis. This decision is based on the mixed results from recent clinical trials, many of which show little to no benefit from these treatments. Furthermore, the high cost of stem cell procedures presents a substantial financial risk, especially considering the uncertainty of their effectiveness.